listening to RPV City Talk. RPV City Talk is brought to you by the City of Rancho Palos Verdes to inform the community on recent city matters. RPV City Talk is a weekly show that features the RPV mayor, city council, or city employees.
Hi everyone, I'm Liz Brown Swanson, and welcome to RPV City Talk. Today we will be talking with our new captain of the Lomita Sheriff Station. It is great to have in our studio Captain Dan Berenger. You are, I should say, you're kind of new to Lomita because you worked at the station for many years prior, but you've been promoted to captain, so congratulations on that.
Thank you, Liz.
And we're glad you're with us on the peninsula. So just for starters, you started in March. How's it going?
It's going fantastic. Everyone has been great since for my return. I've been gone since 2002, but everyone has been so welcoming and great support from the cities. It's been awesome.
I was going to say, but to be back at the Lomita Station, did you see that one coming? Because you said you worked there for about 14 years.
Yeah, I started there in 1988 as a trainee after I did my tour of duty at Men's Central Jail, and worked my way through the ranks. I worked as a detective. I worked on the surveillance and apprehension team. I was promoted to sergeant there in 1999, and I remained and stayed for till 2002.
Well, we're glad you're back. And also, of course, you've replaced Captain Boland, who was promoted to commander. We'll miss him here, but
Big shoes to fill. He's a good man.
We're confident you will be able to fill them. So just expand a little bit more. You've had 30 years with the Los Angeles Sheriff's Department. Why did you want to go into law enforcement and kind of talk about your career path?
Well, actually, I wanted to go into it to make a difference. And it's been a great career. I don't have any complaints. And I've been around the Sheriff's Department my whole life. My father was a lieutenant in the Sheriff's Department, and he retired in 1983.
So following in your dad's footsteps.
Cool. And I've been around the department my whole life.
And you went to school also. You were at college for criminal justice, or what did you study?
I was a criminal justice major at Cal State Long Beach. I graduated in 85.
So your first job was where?
With the Sheriff's Department?
Yeah.
Was at Men's Central Jail after the academy.
And so how much time do you have to spend there? Is that sort of how you start your path?
1 year and 11 months.
You were counting.
Yes, I was.
And then from there you were placed where?
I was placed at Lomita Station.
Okay. So you're familiar with the peninsula. Now that you're back, a lot of things must have changed, though. I think you've been gone for over 10 years as well, right?
Yes, I've been gone since 2002. A lot has changed, but a lot remains the same. The community still has the nice semi-rural feel to it. Community members are very supportive of the Sheriff's Department, and it's great to be back.
Great. What do you see as your vision now that you're back here as captain, and some of your goals, your priorities?
My number one priority right now is public safety, obviously. We're facing some major challenges in law enforcement throughout the state due to prison realignment and Prop 47. We saw marked increases the last few years in property crimes and violent crimes. In this area, mainly property crimes, residential burglary had some major spikes. So my number one goal is to attack that and to get the community involved to help us out and be our eyes and ears.
Get that community involved, exactly. We keep telling everyone, when you see something, say something. You mentioned that. You know, we have seen an uptick in burglaries over the last 5 years on the peninsula. You know, residents are much more, I want to say, high alert. They're paying attention, which is a good thing. To be paying attention. What are the latest stats, though? We see they're showing a better trend, right? We've seen the burglaries coming down right now. The
preliminary numbers for 2016, they're optimistic. It looks like we have about 30 burglaries, residential burglaries, for the first quarter of the year. Those numbers are preliminary. But it's a good sign, but I'm cautiously optimistic.
Right.
We can't let our guard down, and we still need to be vigilant.
I know, because I think we all know here that we are still one of the safest communities in the state. But again, you need to still be on top of everything. And that's why groups like Neighborhood Watch and all of that, we need to be involved and look out for each other.
Absolutely.
Community policing, in a sense, right?
Right.
You really, really depend on that. Even though we are seeing some burglaries on the decline, there's not really any way to figure out why that happens. Is it because maybe you're solving more cases, you're catching the bad guys, or
it's possible there were some significant arrests in December and January that we've publicized, and we want to send a message out there that this community has a reputation for not tolerating crime, and we hope that message is getting out there. And the city has been very supportive with our public safety strategic plan. The council has been giving us overwhelming support with that, and we need to move forward and stick with the plan.
So you mentioned that the RPV, the City Council's public safety strategic plan, which They're in the process of implementing. They're putting more resources, basically, to get behind to support the Sheriff's Department and to help prevent crime. One of the things, you were at the City Council meeting last night.
Yes.
Making your debut as captain, yes. Right? How'd that go, by the way?
It was great.
And one thing that came up is this new idea of putting out a lot more of the license. I can never, LPR cameras.
Automated license plate reader cameras. We'll get it, ALPR. Yeah.
We're going to put a lot of those around our community as well as all over the peninsula. You have the other cities working together. What's going on with that program?
A little bit about those cameras. They read license plates. They cover various lanes and strategic locations around the peninsula. If there's a stolen vehicle or a wanted vehicle, a vehicle associated with a missing person, we'll get an immediate alert sent to the station. A photograph of that vehicle's license plate in the back of the car or the front of the car, whichever view it picks up, will go to the dispatch and we'll send units to try to locate it. The plus side of that is there's a back-end system that investigators can, if they have a partial license plate from a violent crime or a serious crime, they can go in there and run that partial plate and see if they can find a match. So it's a very valuable tool for investigations down the road.
It'll be helpful. And what I did mention was that all the cities are working together, Rolling Hills Estates, and Palos Verdes Estates, which has their own police department. And I think one of the council members pointed out, in a sense, it's historic to get them on board to work entirely as one peninsula.
It's fantastic, and every city's working together very well.
So that's good. And so when will we see those cameras roll out? Do you know?
We're in the early stages of the purchasing contract, so I don't have a timeline for installation, mm-hmm. but hopefully very soon.
You did mention about the city, the city of RPV in the last year has added more revenue, spending more dollars. We have two designated patrol cars to Rancho Palos Verdes. You know, all these things are they making a difference?
I believe so. We had a downtick in the burglaries and we hope to see improvement in our response times, and obviously with two extra cars on the hill, we'll have more visibility. And the Peninsula Cities combined also purchased another surveillance detective for the SAT team, Surveillance and Apprehension Team. So that's another valuable tool.
That will make a difference. Right, because you've just started up, now we're getting into the budget season. You'll be working on what the budget will be that you'll need. But you're already getting a feel for, do you think you're going to need more resources to get the job done that your team is trying to do?
At this point, where the city has purchased these new items recently, so we're just implementing right at the beginning of the budget season.
Okay.
So I think it'll work its way into the budget as we look forward to next year.
Right. What do you see as some of your challenges right now that you've just started and just trying to keep our community safe?
One of the biggest challenges is to change the culture. A lot of people feel safe in the semi-rural community and leave their cars unlocked. Sometimes their garage doors open. I don't want people to live in fear, but I want the awareness out there that they have to be vigilant. And the days of leaving our houses unlocked, they're gone.
Right. I was going to say, any other advice you have for all residents in terms of what they can do to better protect themselves, not to be a victim, as well their home? Like you just mentioned, obviously locking up, but what are some other obvious things? Do you get a dog?
A dog. Get to know your neighbors. Have that relationship with your neighbors. So if you're going out of town, let your neighbors know. No one should be at my house. Keep an eye on it for me. It's not a good idea to stop services like cable or mail or anything if you're going to be gone for the long term, because that information's out there then.
Okay.
So it's better just to have a neighbor or a family member or a friend come by the house and check on it periodically. But to have your neighbors watch and have that established relationship.
And, of course, you are the Sheriff's Department. You have volunteers on patrol that are out there that will do things like vacation checks and things like that to help.
Yes, anyone can call Lomita Station and ask for a vacation check. We have volunteers on patrol that do that every day.
Right. One thing, back to that City Council meeting and rolling out extra steps you're trying to take, there was a reference to maybe what's going to be like a vacation camera that you can rent out or take out, or what was that all about?
Yeah, we're in the early planning stages with that, working with the city staff. It would be a camera that the resident could check out if they're going on vacation, and it would be motion activated and connect to the internet. And if there was a trigger to the camera, we'd get a 10-second video clip in our dispatch center. And if we saw an intruder, we could send cars right away.
Okay.
It's just another tool. And the technology today, I recommend there's some very, very inexpensive home surveillance systems that you can easily install yourself, that you can check your home on your cell phone.
Okay. I know. We have an alarm system now. We haven't had one, you know, never did for years, but all of it helps. Is there any kind of new programs you've had? You know, you've had 30 years working with the Sheriff's Department. Now that you've worked different places, now that you're back at Lameda, is there any type of programs you'd be really excited to now start up here?
Well, the new technologies we're implementing, the Sheriff's Department right now is looking at predictive policing software. It basically is a computer software system that takes crime data and predicts where crime is more likely to occur. So it would tell a deputy on the computer in the car that this particular square of a grid of a map, this is a good place to be. So if the deputy has reports to write, that's a place to park and be visible.
Interesting.
And the Sheriff's Department is testing several software platforms, and I anticipate that we'll be pushing that out department-wide in the near future. Just another tool.
And the tools that are out there, the technology, over the years, you've seen great changes. And just like, as a resident at home, you know, you can go on, what is it, crime mapping, and there's different ways to kind of find out what's happening. Do you have any particular, I know there's Nixle, things that you recommend for the community to stay, you know, alert and what's going on?
I recommend Nixle. Joining Nixle for Lameda Sheriff Station will put out crime information and traffic information if there's a major road closure. Also, follow us on Facebook and Twitter and our LA Sheriff's Lameda Station website.
You have that. You have a great Facebook page. And the website, by the way, is lameda.lasd.org if you want to go on. And you've got an amazing website. You can kind of find out about everything that's going on and volunteer opportunities, which was what I'd like to talk to you about next, because you really do rely on volunteers for lots of different programs.
We do. We are looking for volunteers all the time. We have a volunteers on patrol program, and our volunteers wear uniforms and drive around white cars. They do vacation checks. They can help direct traffic at accident scenes. And just they're out, more eyes and ears out there for us. They have a radio, so if they see anything suspicious or find someone in need of help, they can call us immediately.
And so, but you do need more. I think you've got...
We can always use more, yes.
And there's training involved. First, you have to obviously fill out an application, which I understand you go right to the sheriff's station at Lameda Station.
Yes.
And pick that up.
Yes.
And then once you get cleared, you can't have
there's
a record.
There's a background process and fingerprinting to go through, and then training.
Right. But it's incredible. I met up with some of the volunteers on patrol just recently putting together a story, and just about the ability to give back. And you don't have to have a background in law enforcement. I think some people
Absolutely not.
Yeah. I talked to a guy who was in corporate America, and he finds it incredibly rewarding to know that he is seeing things out there and reporting them and having an impact.
They are definitely making a difference.
Absolutely. Just on a personal note here, just getting to know a little bit more about you. You are, the peninsula is a very special place to you for starters. You got married here.
I did. My wife of 28 years is a RPV native. She graduated from Rolling Hills High School and worked at Marineland. And we were married at St. John Fisher Church, and our reception was at La Vente and in PV Estates.
So this is like coming home.
It's like coming home.
She must have been thrilled to have you back here. And you have two daughters?
I have two daughters, one in college in Boston, and another one is a senior in high school.
So you're busy with all that, and you commute up from Huntington Beach right now.
Yes.
Yeah. Now that you're back on the peninsula, it seems the same. And I mean, that Terranera Resort is, Trump Golf Course, a lot more here since when you left.
Yes, a lot more developed with those properties, but it still has the same feel to it, and I feel great to be back.
You know, one thing that has come up a lot, too, because some of us here that live here will say this is sort of becoming Los Angeles' playground. We have all of our beautiful parks, the resort, and because of that, and social media has put us on the map, we're seeing a lot more activity, which makes it probably a little bit busier for all of you at the Sheriff's Department.
It does.
Trying to manage all what's happening here.
It does. Like I said, the city council has been very supportive. They recently added two more deputies for the preserve, and they will take over ranger duties and be visible out there to deal with those visitors that don't always respect the environment or follow the rules.
Okay. Now that you've just started, what are sort of the top things you're hoping to accomplish in the upcoming months?
What's
on your to-do list?
I'd like to continue the downward trend on crime rates and get the deputies more involved in the cities. The deputies really feel like they're part of the community, and they take it personally when a crime occurs in their area during their shift.
Mm-hmm.
Like they should have been there. So I want to continue that and work on the community policing.
And you mentioned a lot of the staff is there that was there when you were there.
Yes, that's correct. It's a great family station, and we don't have a lot of turnover. People like working there.
Yeah.
I have deputies there that I trained when I was a training officer. They're still there.
And you said I'm back, yeah. And any particular highlights, though, in your career path that you think sort of prepared you for this position to be in charge?
Yes, absolutely. When I left in 2002, I went to Lenox Station, and I became the service area sergeant for the city of Lawndale. So I managed the contract there as a sergeant and went to all the city council meetings and learned how the city operates. And later that prepared me for my last position, which was a lieutenant for the city of Lakewood.
Okay. Well, we're glad we got you here. Anything you want to add you want the community just to understand, to know now that you're in charge, and we're going to hope we're going to have you here for a while?
Well, I hope to be here for the duration, and I am happy to be back, and we're looking for volunteers.
Yeah.
And if you see something, say something, please call the station if anything's out of place.
Okay. And again, the website, too, where you get all the information is lamita.lasd.org. Captain Barringer, it's great to have you. We look forward to working together and being out there, community, and thank you for trying to keep us safe.
Well, thank you, Liz. I appreciate it.
And we'll be seeing you at every city council meeting now, too, right?
Every city council meeting.
That's right. All right. We look forward to that. All right. Well, congratulations on your promotion and being here. And that will do it for this edition of RPV City Talk. I'm Liz Brown Swanson. See you next time. Have a great day, everybody.